So, good morning and welcome back to Daily Transfer Update. Today it's the 1st of July, which means we no longer employ Danny Welbeck, Aaron Ramsey, Petr Cech, or Stefan Lichtsteiner. As we know, Cech's back at Chelsea. Ramsey's gone to Juventus. They're signing Adrian Rabiot as well. That should be going through and being announced probably later on today if it hasn't already been officially. I haven't checked Juventus' Twitter, but I did see yesterday that they had highlights and clips of him landing at Turin Airport on a private jet and being whisked off to sign the contract. So that's a target that we were linked to a lot over the summer. I never really felt we were in for him. I never really felt we would get him. And good luck to him at Juventus, I suppose, along with Aaron Ramsey. But it is also a day when a lot of players become free transfers. And let's start off with a free transfer. And that is Yacine Brahimi, the Porto or ex-Porto winger now. He is available on a free transfer, as I've just said. And we're in advanced talks and negotiations with him and his agent. And he is currently at the African Cup of Nations, which is due to end very soon. Now, we were linked to him back in January, and we were very close to signing him in January. Obviously, we couldn't sign him unless it was a free transfer or a loan, because we couldn't add to the wage bill. So we've waited, we've bided our time, and it does look like we're close to signing him if you read all the reports that are out today. This story broke yesterday, and like I said, the reports are suggesting that that we're in for him and that it's going to get done. Now, we shall see what happens. Like I said, he's at the African Cup of Nations, and no actual answer on his future is going to be announced until it's finished. His record at Porto is pretty decent, to be fair. 215 games. He scored 54 goals and got 43 assists in that time. Now, as far as free transfers go, this is not a bad free transfer. Obviously, we need a winger. He's a good winger. The only thing that puts me off of this transfer is the fact of his age, and he's 29 years old. So, you know, how long does he have left to cut it at the highest level? Excuse me. So we'll probably stick him on a three-year deal, but that means there'll be no sell-on fee at the end of it. And you know, whilst it's not my money, that's going out on his wages or his signing on fee, it does concern me slightly that we're looking at players now that are free and 29 years old. We went down the free route with Kolasinac. We did a swap deal with Mkhitaryan and Alexis Sanchez. And, you know, these players are coming towards the end of their careers. It's not players that are coming into the prime of their careers, but with that being said, I think he is a very good player and I think he would improve us. So, you know, we'll wait and see what happens. I'm sure in the next 7 to 10 days, we'll see some players coming through the door. He could be one of them. Now, leave it in the comments section down below. Let me know what you think of him. Do you think he can cut it in the Premier League? Listen, he lit up the Portuguese league. I thought he did very, very well out there. And when he played in the Champions League, I think he's always done reasonably well in that as well. And you know, we've seen him play against English teams over the years and he's been a part of that. So, yeah, I think I'd take him, to be honest with you. It could save us 25 million getting him rather than getting Ryan Fraser or Yannick Carrasco in that position. So, I don't know. I would be open to him coming. But like I said, the fact that he is 29 years old, is he gonna come in and hit the ground running and be a good player for us for the next 2 to 3 seasons and help us progress up the table? Because we badly need that right now as a football club. We can't be taking any half chances anymore. We have to be getting players that are ready for now, which he is. But I would rather go for somebody a little bit younger that would have a sell-on fee. Which brings me nicely on to somebody I spoke about in a stream yesterday. If you haven't seen that stream, by all means, go and check it out. It was the last one I did at 9 o'clock. And that is Malcolm, the Brazilian international that is currently at Barcelona and having a torrid time at Barcelona. You know, he's out of favour. He's not going to be at Barcelona past this summer. They brought him in last season for £37 million. He's got 4 years left on his contract. He is only 22. Now, this is something I would be open to doing. I think it'd be fantastic. Maybe get him and get Brahimi. You know, he's out of favour at Barcelona. They need to raise some funds. Obviously, seeing their rivals Madrid go and blitz £200 million on five or six players. So I think this would be an ideal signing for Arsenal. And I think that the fact that we could get him for about £30 million would represent good business. He's young enough to come in. If he does well in the Premier League, his value and his stock's going to rise. So surely that would be a decent signing, I think. The one thing that would put me off this guy is the fact that when he left France to go to Barcelona, he hasn't really done it. He's only scored 4 goals, a couple of assists, and only appeared in 24 games. So, you know, it's not great, but at the same time, Barcelona was probably a step too soon for him. He went when he was 21. He maybe needed a move before that to get to that level. Because Barcelona, listen, they don't hold any prisoners over there. If you don't cut it, you're gone. Simple as that. There's no mucking about with him. And he is going to be gone at the end of this transfer window. I fully believe that. Now, Tottenham are linked to him as well. And as I spoke about yesterday on my stream, they've already got Eric Lamella. They've already got Heung-Min Son. And they have already got Lucas Moura. I don't personally think they want him. I think that's maybe his agent putting that out there, that Tottenham are interested to try and speed us up, to try and make us pay the right money and stuff like that. I personally don't think Tottenham do want him. I think Tottenham are quite comfortable in that position, if we're being honest. They've got 3 good players in that position that can all do a job for them and all have done a job for them over the years. So I think it would probably only be us that are in for him. Whether we get him or not remains to be seen. But I would be happy if we got him, the same as I'd be happy with Brahimi. Like I said, Brahimi, the age scares me a little bit, but I'd like to think he'd come in and just go bang straight away. With Malcolm, it might be a little bit of a slow burner, but I do think that he can come in and do a fantastic job for us as well. So leave it in the comments section. Let me know your thoughts on Malcolm as well. Would you take him at Arsenal? For those who watched the stream yesterday, apologies that I've gone over it again. But a lot of people don't watch the streams that watch the Daily Transfer Update. Now, last but by no means least is Scodman Mustafi. Now, I don't even know how I've missed this, to be honest with you. About a month ago, he came out and basically defended his performances. I don't know how that has even come out and I've missed it. I genuinely don't know how I missed it, but there we go. Anyway, this is what he had to say when he said this statement. For me personally, it's not getting to me because our jobs as defenders is to try not to concede goals. But if you make 90% of your job and in the 10% your opponent scores a goal, people forget about the 90%. If a striker misses a goal or a penalty or whatever, you get a new opportunity 5 or 10 minutes later. For us defenders, you make one mistake and they score. Even if in 5 minutes you save something on the line, people won't talk about it and it will live with you because it's part of your job. Now, whilst I kind of agree with him, let me just finish that statement actually. We are a team who are in a lot of games and want to press high up the pitch, which gives teams an opportunity to score goals against us. I think that's maybe having a snide little dig at the manager, basically deflecting his performances onto the manager. But at the same time, listen, this guy is not good enough. And the reason we've brought him up, and I've brought him up this morning, is because Fenerbahce were linked to him last week. They can't raise the £25 million for the length of the contract and the fee and stuff like that, because they are under financial fair play. So I can't even speak, it's way early in the morning. They are under financial fair play, the same as every other team in Europe. They need to sell players before they can buy. Now, they haven't got that many great assets that they can shift out of the club to go and spunk 25 million on Scodran Mustafi. So their representatives are coming over to England this week to talk about a one-year loan deal with an option to buy at the end of it. Now, if that happens, get him on the first flight. I spoke about this the other day when I spoke about Mustafi and Fenerbahce. Get him on the first flight. I don't need to say any more about the guy. I don't want to see him in an Arsenal shirt going into next season. Leave it all in the comments section. Let me know your thoughts on all 3 of the players I spoke about. Would you sign the 2 wingers? Would you keep Scodran Mustafi or would you get rid of him? I will be back at 5 o'clock today with my live stream and again at 9 o'clock. So until then, subscribe if you're new, not far off 20k now. Leave a like on the video and leave your comments down below. Happy Monday. Laters, peeps.